James 23. Will Jesus continue to fill your life? Have you thought about how you are going to serve him and his kingdom? Will your decisions revolve around him and his concerns? How much do you think about how you can clear the picture? Now, if you have questions to pay new service to the King, and just try to squeeze Jesus into the edges of our lives, from the beginning of your life, the way we want to. But if Jesus really is God to help you, then you can't just squeeze him into the edges of your lives. And you will serve him, you will work with him, you will let him squeeze some of the most important things in your life. If you don't care, if we will teach a human by this king of your life, we don't know what the substance is going to be in the last question. Would you want to be served by that? Why not be by justice and righteousness? Are you going to be saved by yourself? And I'm going to be saved by your service to the kingdom with justice and righteousness. And this time forward and forevermore. Because there's a real world of rule by justice and righteousness. But you see, there was people. Do you know that it's right for wrongdoers to come to account? Because You need to be very careful about what you ask for from God. For if God sends his king to bring perfect justice to all everyone to account for how they're having their lives, then what does that mean for you and for me? Are you ready to meet your king and make you better than you were yesterday? And will judge him with perfect justice and perfect righteousness. What if you could have something in your life that is totally restored? Of the sufficient life that you have, that every action that you have ever taken, every word that you have said in your life, everything that you have felt that you should have been. I'm not saying that you have a word that you have said in your life. What would have been? What would have been for? Hatred? Violence? Greed? What would those things say about your attitude and my attitude toward God and man? Would it reveal a deep love for God? Or would it reveal somebody who ignores God and rejects him? Because we see many things in our life that are available, we see it all. We see it as well as financial development, and we see it as well as justice. Our personal level, we see conflict in our relationships, we see it in our hunting, we see it in our learning, we see it for the safety of our children. We see the crime guilt, we fear death, we fear because there are things in this world that are frightening. And yet, what our eyes fear is that the biggest thing that you and I need to fear is not these things, but God himself. For if God and his king is going to bring justice and righteousness into this world forever, it will mean of those that have ignored and who have rejected God and his king. See, it is terrifying thing to fall into the hands of a king who brings justice and righteousness. If you are on the wrong side of justice and righteousness, the wonderful thing. What we find in the book of Isaiah is that God's king is also the one who comes to serve sinners. And so much earlier, the three weeks that his words of Isaiah say there, that this king that is spoken about is also a servant. He speaks of a servant king who comes to serve his people, to heal for our transgressions and for our iniquities. This servant king is the one who comes to die in our place for our sins. He pays the price of God's justice for us. He was a servant sinners like us, not a servant of our sin, and turn to God and find mercy and forgiveness. So often, we have to give servant Thank you. Thank you.